all about you. Oh, Jesus. When the music fades, all is stripped away, and I simply come, longing just to bring something that's of worth, that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things have been. You're looking into my heart. I'm coming back, I'm coming back to the heart of love. It's all about you. It's all about you. It's all about you. It's all about you. Lord, lift up our hands to say it's all about you. King of endless wealth, King of endless worth, no one could express. Though I'm weak and poor, and all I have is yours. Every single breath, I'll bring you more than a song. For a song in itself is not what you require. You search more deeper within. Through the way things appear, all you're looking into my heart. Say I'm coming back. It's all about you. It's all about you. I'm sorry, Lord. It's all about you. I'm coming back. Singing, it's all about you, Jesus. It's all about you, Jesus. And I'm sorry, Lord. It's all about you. Say I'm coming, Lord. It's all about you. It's all about you. Say I'm sorry. Say it's all about you. Celebrate a God, celebrate a God, celebrate a God. Oh, what are you turning to wine? You open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you, no like you. Say into the darkness you shine, and out of the ashes we rise. No one like you. Say no like you. Hey, our God is greater, our harder and stronger. Lord, you are higher than any other. I got a zeal, awesome in power. I got. Say, I got is greater.
Is
strong.
I got is stronger.
Is higher.
Lord, you are
You open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you. No like you. Say into the darkness.
Into the darkness you shine.
Say I re-achieve.
Out of the arches you rise.
No one like you.
No one like you.
Say there's no like you.
No like you.
Say I got it. God is
healer,
awesome in power.
Awesome in power, I got.
That's I got.
I got.
Say I got is greater.
I got is greater.
It's stronger.
I got is stronger.
There's no one.
You are higher than any other.
I got is healer, awesome in power.
Awesome in power, I got.
Yeah, I got.
I got.
In this, and if I got is for us, then stop us, and if our God is with us, no one can stand against.
And if our God is for us,
then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, say,
and if our God is for us,
yeah,
no,
no,
and if our God is with us,
no one can stand.
And
if our God
is for us, and if our God is with us,
say,
no one can stand.
God is stronger, Lord, you are higher than any other. I got his healer, awesome in power. I got, say, I got. Turn, you open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you. No. Out of the ashes,
you rise.
No one
like
you.
No one like you.
There will never be anyone like you. Say, I got is greater.
I got is greater.
It's stronger.
I got is stronger.
It's fine.
But you are higher than
order. Any other.
I got is healer.
Oh, awesome in power, I got.
I got
is
greater,
God is stronger,
Lord,
you are
higher than any other.
I got is healer, awesome in power, I got. If for us, then who could ever stop us?
And if our God is with us,
no one can stand
against.
For us.
No one could ever stop
no,
us.
No one.
And if our God is with us,
oh, no one can stand against. And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, no one can stand against. And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, no one can stand against. Your name is Yahweh. name is Yahweh. You are the miracle working God. Your name is Yahweh. Say Yahweh. Say Yahweh.
Thank you so much, our choir, for that wonderful rendition and for the wonderful voices of the Melody Grateful Church Choir. We thank you. We appreciate you for that. You're welcome once again, brethren, to today's one in this program. Today is our communion service. So this is a prayer session. So let us just pray. Let's begin to just appreciate the Almighty God for bringing us here today, for making it worthy for us to be here in presence. Prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, King of Kings, we just want to say thank you. We give you glory. We appreciate your holy name for making it possible for us to be in your presence once again today. This time last week, we were here, and now you've brought us here safely in one accord, Lord Father. We just want to appreciate your holy name. We just want to say thank you. Let's just thank him for that. There's so many people, they couldn't even see the light of the day. Yes, they couldn't see the light of the day, but God made it possible for us from last week till this present moment. We did not receive any evil news from anyone of our church members. We did not say we are grieving anyone on the church members. We did not say no one is currently in the hospital or neither are some people accidented. Let's just begin to appreciate Almighty God for that grace, because he only is the one that made it possible for us to be here. Let's begin to thank him. Lord, we say thank you. Lord, we appreciate your holy name for bringing us here today again in your presence. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. I would like us to also thank God for the wonderful things he has been doing for the Grateful Church, that the Almighty God has started this wonderful stuff in our lives, that the Almighty God should continue to take us to the next step. Prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Rock of Ages, we want to say thank you. We thank you for the wonderful things that you've been doing in our church. We thank you because we know that only you can continue to do greater things for us. We say thank you, Father. We appreciate your holy name on that. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. As we know that today is our communion service, I just want us to just take just a little minute to reflect on our life, to reflect on how we were doing as a believer in general in these trying times and in this current environment that we are in. There is a lot of things going against the believers. Yes, there's a wind that is going against the believers. So let's just reflect on ourselves. Are we working in God's path? Are we doing everything as He instructed us to do? Let's just reflect on that. Yes, I know that we have done this reflection, and I know within us we can know, we can tell if truly we have been doing all that God has instructed. But God is a merciful God. So therefore, before we take the communion, I would like us to ask God for mercy, that God should forgive us our trespasses, that the Almighty God should have mercy on us, that mercy should speak for us. He says mercy precedes even in the presence of the judgment. The Almighty God should have mercy. Prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Rock of Ages, we just want to say, have mercy on us. We know that we are sinners. We ask for forgiveness of sins, Father. We repent and we confess our trespasses into your hands, Father. Please have mercy on us. Forgive us our trespasses in the mighty name of Jesus. Forgive us every sin that we have committed in the name of Jesus. By the virtue of taking this communion, Lord, renew our strength in you. Renew our spiritual life in you. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Let's now tell God that God, as we are going to be taking this communion, that Father, Lord, everything that has been dead in our lives, knowingly or unknowingly, that we even know about or we don't even know about, it could be missed opportunities that might have come for us, but in one way or another, it could be by our negligence. Yes, it could be by procrastination that made us to lose that opportunity, to lose that step, that God, by the reason of taking this today, that God Almighty is a God of second chance, that He should redirect our steps and create opportunities for us so that we can forge ahead. The Almighty God should do that. Prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, King of Kings, Rock of Ages, Lord, by the reason of this communion service tonight, every opportunity we've lost, everything that has been dead in our lives, God, please revive it for us in the name of Jesus. As we partake in this today, Lord, revive every dead activities in our life, dead opportunities in our lives. Is it the talents that God has given us, talents that has been dead, that God should revive it in the name of Jesus? Is it the glory that God has given unto us that has been taken away from us, that God Almighty should revive it and collect our glory back for us in the name of Jesus Christ? In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Let's also tell God that God, as we partake this, Lord, spiritually, Lord, let us continue to grow. Yes, let us continue to grow spiritually, because we know the spiritual controls the physical. We just don't want to appear to be excelling in the physical world, and therefore our spiritual life is lacking. That God should Himself revive and send the fire of the revival in our spirit life. Prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh Lord, my Father, as we take this, Lord, our spiritual life that has been struggling, God Almighty, please revive it for us in the name of Jesus. Revive our spiritual life for us in the mighty name of Jesus. In any way, Lord, that we have been lacking spiritually, continue to revive us in the name of Jesus. By taking this, God Almighty, revive us in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Let's now tell God that God Almighty, as we are taking this, we are using ourselves as a point of contact to every of our church members, every of our family members, even ourselves, Lord, in whatever sickness that is in the body, any sickness that we might have been experiencing, any sickness, regardless of whatever the doctor says, the Almighty God is the only surgeon, is the one that created us. So yes, He has the chemistry just right in His hands. All He just needs to do is just to touch and lay His hands on us. That God, as we are taking this, whatever sickness is in our body, that the Almighty God should clear it away in the name of Jesus, and He should make us whole again in the mighty name of Jesus. Sickness is not our portion. Sickness should not have any place in our homes. Prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Rock of Ages, Lord, as we take this, Lord, by using ourselves as a point of contact to the remaining church members, to our family, Lord, even to ourselves, Lord, that God Almighty, every sickness, infirmities that we know that we are hiding in our clothes, that we can't even say it out, that we are experiencing this, God Almighty, please cleanse us in the name of Jesus. Cleanse us of those in the name of Jesus. You are the only God that healeth. You are the only God that perfect healing. God Almighty, please cleanse us of such infirmities in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Let's just commit the rest of the program into God's hands. The Father, Lord, as we continue, you will take control. We just don't want to partake this just for doing sake. That we want you to come into us. We want you to minister into us personally. We want you to touch us today and make today a memorable day in our lives. Prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we commit the rest of the program into your able hands, Lord. Father, please touch us. We just don't want to do this for doing sake, for saying, oh, I've done the communion and that is. No, we don't want to take it in flesh, Lord. We want you to take it in the spirit. And we want you to touch us, Father. We want you to minister to us. We want you to perfect everything that has to do with us in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be in the name of Jesus. And we want it to be a memorable day in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Let's also commit the man of God that he will be using for us tonight. That everything that it comes through him, that Father, Lord, we want to hear from you directly. We don't want to hear from him because he's a man of God. No, we want to hear from you directly. Lord, use him as a vessel tonight in the name of Jesus. Use him as a vessel to perform wonders in our lives today. Use him as a vessel to touch our lives. Use him as a vessel, Lord, to take us to the next level tonight in the name of Jesus. Let's begin to pray. Father, Lord Almighty, we commit your man of God, your son that will be using for us tonight. Lord, let your anointing and your words flow through him in the name of Jesus. Lord, renew his strength, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Perfect everything that has to do with him in the name of Jesus Christ. We want to hear from you directly. We don't want to hear from him as a man. Lord, so shall it be for us today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Let's just pray this prayer for our children, that God Almighty should be with our children. It is very important. There's so many news that are circulating right now. News of stabbing, news of gang activities, fight everywhere. Even people that know nothing about them, you hear this news, oh, this has been killed, this has been kidnapped, this has been murdered. That God should continue to just keep our children. Yes, it is important. We will not mourn over any of our children. Prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. God Almighty, you gave us these children. Said children are your heritage, Lord. Father, please, anywhere and everywhere our children might be, God be with them. Guide them, Lord. We don't want to mourn and cry over any of the children in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We don't want to hear evil news over anyone. We don't want anyone to be stabbed. We don't want anyone to become a victim of gang fight in the name of Jesus Christ. We don't want them to say, oh, it was in the right place at the wrong time. That is not our portion. In the name of Jesus Christ, so shall it be in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Let us pray. In Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus, King of Kings, we say thank you. We glorify your holy name for this wonderful time in your presence. We thank you for everything you've been doing for us from the beginning of this month up until the beginning of this week and up until today. We appreciate your holy name, Father, for your faithfulness over our lives, for your kindness over our lives, and for your wonderful protection, for protecting us. Lord Almighty, we say thank you. Accept our thanks and praises in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you once more, Father, for bringing us to this very moment. Thank you for this program. We thank you for the rest of this program. We thank you because we know that you take absolute control. We thank you because we know that you will touch our lives tonight. We thank you because we know that you will renew our strength in you. You will renew our faith in you, and you will renew everything that has to do with us. In the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you because we know that our spiritual life shall be back up, Papa, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for answering our prayers. We worship and we glorify your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen.
Proverbs chapter 10.
The Proverbs of Solomon. A wise son maketh a glad father, but a foolish son is the heaviness of his mother. Treasures of wickedness profit nothing, but righteousness delivereth from death. The Lord will not suffer the soul of the righteous to famish, but he casteth away the substance of the wicked. He becometh poor that dealeth with a slack hand, but the hand of the diligent maketh rich. He that gathereth in summer is a wise son, but he that sleepeth in harvest is a son that causeth shame.
Blessings are upon the head of the just,
but violence covereth the mouth of the wicked.
The memory of the just is blessed,
but the name of the wicked shall rot.
The wise in heart will receive commandments,
but a prating fool shall fall.
He that walketh uprightly walketh surely,
but he that perverteth his ways shall be known. He that winketh with the eyes causeth sorrow, but a prating fool shall fall.
The mouth of a righteous man is a well of life,
but violence covereth the mouth of the wicked. Hatred stirreth up strifes,
but love covereth all sins. In the lips of him that hath understanding, wisdom is found.
But a rod is for the back of him that is void of understanding.
Wise men lay up knowledge,
but the mouth of the foolish is near destruction.
The rich man's wealth is his strong city.
The destruction of the poor is their poverty.
The labor of the righteous tendeth to life,
the fruit of the wicked to sin.
He is in the way of life that keepeth instruction,
but he that refuseth reproof erreth. He that hideth hatred with lying lips, and he that uttereth a slander, is a fool. In the multitude of words there wanteth not sin,
but he that refraineth his lips is wise. The tongue of the just is as choice silver.
The heart of the wicked is little worth.
The lips of the righteous feed many,
but fools die for want of wisdom.
The blessing of the Lord, it maketh rich, and he addeth no sorrow with it.
It is as sport to a fool to do mischief,
but a man of understanding hath wisdom.
The fear of the wicked, it shall come upon him,
but the desire of the righteous shall be granted.
As the whirlwind passeth, so is the wicked no more,
but the righteous is an everlasting foundation.
As vinegar to the teeth, and as smoke to the eyes, so is the sluggard to them that send him.
The fear of the Lord prolongeth days,
but the years of the wicked shall be shortened.
The hope of the righteous shall be gladness,
but the expectation of the wicked shall perish.
The way of the Lord is strength to the upright,
but destruction shall be to the workers of iniquity.
The righteous shall never be removed,
but the wicked shall not inhabit the earth.
The mouth of the just bringeth forth wisdom,
but the froward tongue shall be cut out.
The lips of the righteous know what is acceptable,
but the mouth of the wicked speaketh frowardness.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Good evening, everyone. Wherever you're watching from, a very good evening to you. I greet you in the name of Jesus. I hope your day has been good. I hope it was a very good one. We trust that the Almighty God has been good to you. Praise the Lord. I appreciate those who have officiated in one way or the other before I came up. I want to say God bless you all and thank you for leading us in the way that we should come into the presence of the Lord. Amen. Praise God.
Today is our Holy Communion service. It also doubles as our Bible study too. And today, by God's grace, I'll be sharing with us before we observe the Holy Communion. Please get your wine ready. Get your bread ready. Let's do that. Let's get our wine and our bread ready. And the Almighty God will be there with us as we dine and wine together in his presence. Praise the Lord. Amen. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, we thank you for your love and blessing. We give you all the glory for keeping us alive. We exalt you. We magnify your name. We give you all the glory, all the honor, all the adoration. You are worthy to be praised, worthy to be magnified, worthy to be glorified. You reign supreme, you rule in the affairs of men. Thank you for everything you've blessed us with. Because a man can receive nothing except it be given to him from above. And thank you for so many things that has been given to us from heaven. We are grateful. Father, it's another opportunity for us tonight to dine with you in remembrance of you. We ask that you guide us accordingly. As we look into your word, we ask that you speak to us. Let your word have a place in our hearts, O God. Let your word move us and let it profit us. Take all the glory, mighty God, and all the honor. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. By the grace of God, this evening, before we observe our communion, I have the leading of the Lord to share with us in what he has helped me to title Online Evangelism. Online evangelism. You could also say digital evangelism. Praise the Lord. Online evangelism. You could also say digital evangelism. Amen. It's a divine mandate. It's a divine mandate. And the Almighty God has asked me to share with us tonight. It's a divine mandate, and I pray that understanding shall be given to us in the name of Jesus as we look at this together. Online evangelism. The Almighty God will teach you and I, and he will help us to understand what he wants us to understand as we look into this. Online evangelism. Praise the Lord. Can I ask you to open your Bible with me to 2 Corinthians? 2 Corinthians chapter 10, I'll be reading verse 6. 2 Corinthians chapter 10, and we will be reading verse 6. 2 Corinthians chapter 10. Let's move together to 2 Corinthians chapter 10, and we'll be reading verse 6 only. Amen. Are you there? Now you are very blessed today. It's also displayed on the screen for you. 2 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 6 says, having in a readiness to revenge all disobedience when your obedience is fulfilled. And having in a readiness to revenge all disobedience when your obedience is fulfilled. Can we also take another reading? Bear with me. I will use them all in the teaching. Matthew chapter 5. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 1 to 2. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 1 to 2. The book of Matthew chapter 5, and then we'll be reading from verse 1 to 2. Come with me to Matthew chapter 5, and then read from verse 1 to 2, and it goes thus. And see, Matthew chapter 5, reading from verse 1 to 2. And seeing the multitude, he went up into a mountain, and when he was set, his disciples came unto him. Verse 2. And they opened his mouth, and taught them saying, and then he began to say a lot of things. Thank you. My brother and my sister, tonight, God wants us to talk about the divine mandate in another way. That's what we're looking at. The online evangelism. So you will agree with me that there are different kinds of evangelism, which you know, but today God wants us to discuss online evangelism. Online evangelism. And this is very important. Amen. I need to give you some statistics and I'll begin to speak that will really, really help us. Okay? I want to give us some statistics and we will really begin to speak. And I would love, if you don't mind, that we can make it interactive. You know, we can make it interactive. I can ask questions and then you also ask questions. As of January 2022, as of January 2022, I know we're in 24, these statistics would have been a little bit higher. As of January 2022, the total world population is 7.95 billion. As of January 2022, the total world population was 7.95 billion. So you might agree with me that it would be a little bit higher now, but as at that time, it was 7.795 billion. Take note of this. Somebody might even be writing if you don't mind. Smartphone users all over the world, is at 6.49 billion. Billion people. 6.49 billion people are using smartphones all over the world. Somebody might be writing, this might really help, but I would appreciate if someone is writing. Internet users all over the world, those who are using internet, have access to internet all over the world, 5.34 billion. These are statistics, it's available online. 5.34 billion people have access to internet, are using internet. And active social media users, social media, you know, Facebook, Twitter, Google, WhatsApp, YouTube, active social media users are 5.04 billion. 5.04 billion. Are you getting me? I still have more to show you because we're going to talk using this. Statistics also shows that every minute, more than 1 million people log into Facebook every minute. More than 1 million people log into Facebook, and I'm sure it will be more than that because this is the 2022 statistics. 3.4 million searches are made on Google per minute, not per hour. 3.8 million searches are made on Google. 4.5 million videos are viewed on YouTube. 4.5 million videos are viewed on YouTube. And 347,000 users are using Instagram right now. 347,000 users are scrolling on Instagram right now. Right now, as we are speaking. Brethren, while all the statistics, the Bible is clear that anyone who has encountered Jesus, the Bible says we must be witness. We must be witness for him. Very important. In Acts chapter 1 and verse 8. Acts chapter 1 and verse 8. It says, go ye into the world. And what? Preach the gospel and make disciples. Is there. The divine mandate is there. In Mark chapter 16. This one we're going to read it. Mark chapter 16, reading from verse 14 to 15. Mark chapter 16, reading from verse 14 to 15. So open your Bible with me to Mark chapter 14. This one we're going to read. Mark chapter 14, reading from verse, Mark chapter 16, reading from verse 14 to 16. It says, afterward, he appeared unto the 11 as they sat at meats. That's the Holy Communion. And upbraided them with their unbelief and hardness of heart, because they believed not them which had seen him after he was risen. Verse 15. And he said unto them, go ye. What is said unto them? Beloved, is said unto you and I too, if you believe the Bible. Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel. To what? To who? To who? Not to what? To who? Every creature. Every creature. Every creature. Thank you, sir. That's the divine mandate. But to tonight, God put in my spirit, in my hand, to teach, to tell us, for us to discuss about online evangelism, digital evangelism, digital evangelism. We know we do evangelism, which is the physical one that we do. A lot of you do come, and God bless you. Many of you do not come. God still bless you, but I want you to change. That's why we read the first Bible passage that we read, which we're going to read again. Many a time, some people wonder, why is my prayer not being answered? Why is things looking as if it's difficult for me? Why is my own like this? Perhaps you are a disobedient child of God. Perhaps you are living in disobedience. And you are praying for many things to happen. And it seems not to be happening. And you are praying about this, about that. And it seems to be a struggle. Perhaps they have looked at you from heaven and they are saying you are disobedient. They've looked at you from heaven and they are saying this is a disobedient child of God. Yet a child of God, but a disobedient one. Maybe that's what they are saying in heaven. Brother and sister, let it change. Don't let it be said about you continuously. Let it change. That's what the Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 10. And verse 6. Let's read it again. 2 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 6. Come with me. We need it. We need it. For God wants us to hear it. 2 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 6. It says, and having in a readiness to have revenge or disobedience. Revenging or disobedience is everything that is contrary to what God planned for your life and is happening in your life. That is a disobedience. But the Bible says, how can you revenge it? How can you stop it when your own obedience is fulfilled? When your own obedience is in place? Thank you. Therefore, if God tells you and I to go and evangelize, to go and preach the gospel to every nation, and we are disobeying, do you think that same God will rise up and be willing to be ministering to a disobedient child? No. The Bible says the Almighty God is loving. In Hebrews also, he says he's a consuming fire. He said, whomsoever, those who honor me, he said, I will honor. And those who despise me will be lightly esteemed. Brethren, he has asked me to talk to us about online evangelism. Not evangelism. Online evangelism. That's why I gave you the statistics. With the emergence of digital technology all around us, internet and social media platforms, digital evangelism, online evangelism is an effective means of reaching the world. An effective means of telling people about Jesus, about the gospel of Christ. And brethren, we must engage using it. And brethren, we must do it. We have no excuse before Jesus when we appear before him. We have no excuse because all tools at our disposal, especially digital tools. The social media, the internet is our disposal. It's asking us to engage in using it for his glory. He's speaking to you and I today He's asking us to do this for his glory, to rise up. In the Grateful Church, we have three forms of evangelism. Citywide evangelism, neighborhood evangelism, and online evangelism. Citywide evangelism, you see, we go out. We go out physically to the street, vicinity of the church, city center sometimes. We go out and share tracts. And those who want to discuss with us, we chat with them. We do that. We also have what we call neighborhood evangelism. Within your vicinity area where you live, in your area where you live, in your streets, in your suburb, in the park, very close to your area, you go share tracts, neighborhood evangelism. You put the tracts in the mailbox of your neighbors, all the houses in your streets. That is neighborhood evangelism. Then we have also in the Grateful Church, online evangelism. How do we do online evangelism? The church shares its messages. If you go on our social media platform, you will see a video of the entire service. And then you will see a video of the message alone. So you can share the video of the message alone or the entire service on your social media platform. And people will hear the word of God. But who made it possible? You. Who will God say made it possible? You, sir. You, ma. Because if somebody is saved, somebody hear the gospel and is saved because you put the message. We also have what we call nuggets. I will show you types of them. Because you put the message or you put a nugget of our message. We have nuggets of our message. You put it on the social media platform. You know, and somebody sees it and is inspired. Or somebody hears the message and is inspired. You know, and it blesses them. You have done well. You have done what is called online evangelism. And people have been blessed. People have been blessed. People have been spoken to. The Holy Ghost use it. That action of yours, the Holy Ghost use it to talk to the people. Very important. We have loads of them. We have it. You will see nuggets. An example of nugget is what you see to my side there. You see, that's it. That's nuggets there. It is always on our social media platform. You will always see the different types. Every time we have a service, there will be nuggets of the word that were shared. It's there. You will always see it. You can go to our social media platform, the church social media platform, and share it. You can go to the church social media platform and share it. And people will be blessed as you do so in the name of Jesus. That's online evangelism. Some people will hear the word of God. Even those who are already Christian will hear some wisdom of God. That's online evangelism. And what? How is it done? It is the strategic and deliberate use of internet. It has to be deliberate. The deliberate use of internet and social media platform to preach the gospel. You don't need to say anything. This nugget says it. You don't need to say anything. The sermon video says it. You can go to our YouTube channel and pick the share link, and share the message and share it. People do it a lot. Serious Christians, they do it. Share it on your WhatsApp status. Share it on your Facebook status. Share it on your Instagram status. Put your own stuff that you want there. Yeah, sometimes. But share God's stuff also sometimes. That's online evangelism. Let God use you. Let God pass through you. Be a vessel in the hand of the Lord. It is very simple. It is called online evangelism, or as you may want, digital evangelism. This thing we are talking about is simple. It's simple. You know what is also shocking? It costs you nothing, sir. It costs you nothing, ma. Nothing. Facebook is not charging you to use it. LinkedIn is not charging you to use it. YouTube is not charging you to use it. Twitter is not charging you to use it. Instagram is not charging you to use it. Brethren, look at it very well. You and I, we have no excuse. We need to go out there and tell people about Jesus. Share the message on your church social media page. Share it. Broadcast it on your profile. The status, which is 24 hours, let it be there. Words that will encourage people. I'm not saying don't use your social media for your own stuff too, but share with Jesus. Share it with Jesus. Jesus is saying, Peter, can I use your boat? Brethren, your boat is your social media. What do they call it now? Pastor Tope, help me. What do you call it? Is it handle they call it? Platform. Thank you. As Jesus used Peter's boat to evangelize, Jesus is asking for your social media platform. Look at the statistic I gave you. Look at it. 6.49 billion people on smartphone. Social media, 5.04 billion people on social media. As we are speaking now, 347,000 are scrolling on Instagram. Brethren, per minute, I'm not saying per hour, per minute. Imagine if all Christians all over the world begin to share Jesus, 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 Jesus. All Christians all over the world on social media. The 5.04 billion, at least 10% of them, we get something about Jesus. Can you see the possibility of things? God is counting on you. God is counting on me. He's asking, can I use your boats? Can I use your social media platform? Can I use your WhatsApp status? Can I use it? He's asking, can I use it? Can I use your WhatsApp profile picture area? Can I use your WhatsApp status area? Can I use your Facebook, status area? Can I use your Facebook page? Can I use your Facebook profile? Can I? Those 1,500 friends you have, those 1,000 friends you have, those 500 friends you have, can I reach out to them through you? Jesus is asking you. Can I? I died for them too. I died for you, but not only you. I died for them. Can I reach out to them? Jesus is saying, my son, my daughter, you don't need to speak. I will do the speaking. My spirit will do the speaking. Can you just share what is being preached? Can you just share what I said? He's asking you and I. He said, my son, my daughter, you don't need to do the preaching if you are shy. Maybe you are shy. I would love that you do the speech and say some things, but you don't need to. You don't need to. My servant has done what needs to be said. Can you share it? Can you share it? This is a nugget. We also employed somebody to be doing graphics for us so that these things will be possible. And they have done it. If you look at my side, that is the nugget for Sunday message. Nugget from Sunday message. All we just need to do is to go to our social media platform, and share it. The nuggets are there. For Sunday messages, they are there. For Tuesday messages, they are, and Wednesday messages, they are there. We just need to go there and share it. My brother, my sister. We also have small video clips. That the way the graphics and video people do it, they are fantastic people. They do it very well. They will pick where I mentioned some very important words. And they will do a clip of it. Let us share it. Maybe peradventure, you don't like your pastor. You don't like what I said or what I preach. Put your own there. Put your own there. Put your own there. There are people who put their own there. I'll show you. Put your own there. You can put your own there. You can write what you read from your Bible or what God said to you in that day. You can write it there. Sama, you can put your own there. Very important. All we need to do is to share these things for God. You can put your own there. Very, very important. Online evangelism. We have to be strategic about it. We have to be deliberate about it. Sir, let's do this for God. Don't wait until God begins to chastise you. That can't you do this for me? I died for you. Is it too much for me for you to do this for me? Don't wait. Don't wait. Don't wait. Don't wait to begin to be asking you or chastising you that why are you not doing this? Rise up and do it. Rise up and do it. Brother and sister, let us rise up and do this for Christ. This is what he said I should share today. Left for me, this is not what I will want to share today. Because today is the Holy Communion, so I won't want to talk about this. I want to choose another day. But he said I should talk about this. Very important. My brother and sister, I will show you another example of a Christian, what is using his social media platform and all of his platform, what is using it to do. Let me share it with you. That is somebody's social media. That is somebody's Facebook's. That's not Facebook. That's WhatsApp. That's somebody's WhatsApp. How will I call it now? I think it's status. Is it status updates? Whatever we call it. That's somebody. You know? That's one of my daddy friend. This is what he's sharing to people. Brethren, can we do the same and much more? Can we do the same? Can we do the same? God is expecting you and I. Is expecting you and I to reach the world with for him with our social media platform. Will you allow him to use your boat? I want to cry unto you. Allow him. Allow him. Allow him. Allow him. There are so many gadgets that we use now that can do all this thing. Your iPad can do it. Your smartphone can do it. Yes. There are many communication tools to evangelize with. Are you going to do this? Don't be like other Christians. The Bible says in the last day, the love of many will wax cold. The love of many have waxed cold. I was listening to a pastor, and in that, they were giving church statistics. They were giving church statistics, and they said that almost 70%. Almost 70 to 80% of people who relocated from Africa, Christians who relocated from Africa into the Western world, either into US or to UK, somebody said almost 70% of them are not going to church. So they did the statistics that why? They found out that where they were coming from, the African nation that they were coming from, they were not really serving God because they love him. They were serving God because of what they could get from him. So when they got to the Western world and they saw that they could just walk and get this thing easily, they forgot about God. When they were in Africa, they were not serving him because of who he is. They were serving him because of what they could get from him. But they want better life. They want more money. And so when they got to the Western world and they see that easily, somehow, they could get more money, they forgot about him. Is that true? Is that true? Brethren, let's go back to our first love. Let's get back to God. Let's get back to him. He said, go ye. He said, let your obedience be complete. The question we should ask ourselves, when last did I do evangelism? And even the easy one, this is the easiest. When last did I do online evangelism? When last? Very easy to do. All you need to do is to share it right from your phone. And it costs you nothing. It costs you nothing. For you to do neighborhood evangelism, going around your area, you will need to get out of your house and walk down there. For you to do city evangelism, that we do. You need to come to the church, and then we go to the areas, vicinity of the church, or you come to city center. You will need to get up and take some, you know, drive down or take public transport. But online evangelism, right from your phone. You hold your phone as I'm holding my phone, and you do it. That is not a task. That is not a burden. Will you do it, sir? Will you do it for Jesus? Are you going to do it? Are you? He has asked me to encourage you tonight. He has asked me to tell you on his behalf. Well, I was even saying, he was even telling me. He said, don't tell the grateful church that you pastor alone. He asked me to tell many people. And I am going to do it. Every Christian I meet now, I will ask them, brother, have you heard of online evangelism? If you say, what is online evangelism? I will explain it to him. You can do this. He has asked me to tell the whole world. And I am going to do it. I will obey him. I will tell every Christian I meet now. God reminded me about online evangelism. I'm going to make a campaign about it. That Christian, use your WhatsApp status. Use your WhatsApp updates. Use your social media platforms to talk about Jesus. Do it. Let's do it. Let's start from ourselves in the grateful church. Let's go further. Do you know that Apostle Paul, he sent text messages? He sent text messages. You can send text messages to people. You can broadcast WhatsApp messages. You can do a broadcast. Some people will read it, and the Holy Ghost will just minister to their hearts. Your mind might say, not everybody, why? Not everybody need it. Not everybody will want it. Share it. They're not going to be annoyed with you for sharing a text message or updating your WhatsApp status with what you want. It's yours. It's your platform. It's your domain. It's what you want. Let's do this for Christ. Colossians 4. I want to show you something there. I want to tell you. We found out that Paul, he wrote a text message to some people. And you and I have text message now. We even have WhatsApp. We have Telegram. All of them. Instagram. Colossians chapter 4 verse 18. In Colossians chapter 4 verse 18, look at what Paul said. Colossians chapter 4 and verse 18. He was writing a message to the people, to some people. He said, the salutation by my what? By the hand of me, Paul. He was sending a word of encouragement to some people. And then he was ending it. He said, the salutation by the hand of me, Paul. Remember my bonds. Grace be with you. What does that mean? He wrote that letter with his own hand. He wrote the letter with his own hand. He wrote the letter with his own hand. My brother, my sister, thank you. Are you going to take your phone and reach out to many people with your own hand? Are you going to take your phone and reach out to many people with your own hand? After this message, Jesus will be waiting to see if you will do it. Amen. Very important. Please, I want to emphasize this very well. The need for us to plan and use available communication devices at our disposal to win souls for Christ. We need to use available devices at our disposal to win Christ. And one of such is our social media platforms. We really need to do it. We really need to use it to promote the Church of Christ, the message of Christ much more. Very important. And the Lord will help you in Jesus' name. There are positive aspects to social networking. It has overcome, social media now has overcome great barriers and hurdles. There are some nations that the gospel will not be allowed to be preached in a church or on the road. But through social media, you can get the gospel to people in that nation. Yes. Because everybody's on Instagram. A lot of people. They're on social media, on Facebook. They're on Twitter. So, and it is your platform. It is your platform. Nobody stops you from using what you want to use your platform for. You will reach out to people. You will reach out to English-speaking people. Some social media platform, they will even translate your messages for you. Ah, brother, can't you see that? This is a great opportunity. Will you take advantage of it? I will. I will. For Christian social media sites, it can be productively harnessed for kingdom expansion. Social media sites can be productively harnessed for preaching the gospel. Are you going to do it? There are loads of viewers. You check it. Put something on your social, on your WhatsApp update. It will tell you the number of people that have viewed it. You have reached out to those number of people with a word. Put something also on your Facebook page or profile or post. A lot of people will see it. Ah, brother. Ah, sister. The question is, will you do it for Jesus? Will you? Use your friends, your friends list. There are a lot of them. Many of us, our friend list is almost 1,005, some 3,000. WhatsApp status. Tweets. Tweet about Christ. Tweets. We can be writers, you know. We can be content creators, you know. We can be bloggers, you know. And if you're not a blogger, you're not a content creator, you're not a writer, what people have written, share it. Share it. I just told you, the reason why we make all these nuggets, all these nuggets of the preaching after service, is so that it can be shared. So that somebody can just read it. When the time has come, the grace to perform and the grace to fulfill will be released to you. Somebody who is struggling, when he reads this, he will say, ah, Lord, let my time come. Okay, I will wait. I will patiently wait for my time. Such a person will desist from using the alternative or compromising. There are many people that you can save their life. You don't have to be a pastor to be able to preach the gospel. It is easy now. Son, let's take advantage of it. Making use of these digital means to further the gospel, the work of Christ. I want to remind you of something. He will ask you. He will ask you. He will ask you. He will first of all ask you, did you preach the gospel? If you give an excuse, I was busy, I was nurturing my children, I was taking care of my husband, I was attending to my academics, he will tell you. He will give you statistics. He will show you that your phone is in your hand for almost 20 hours of the day or almost 18 hours of the day, apart from the time that you are sleeping. He will tell you that your phone is with you. Let's be generous. Oh, he will tell you that your phone is with you for almost half of the day, 12 hours. He said you could have used it. He will remind you of this teaching that you were reminded, you were told to use your social media platform to preach my gospel. Did you do it? Did you do it? He will ask you. He will. That's what the Bible says. When your obedience is complete, is your obedience complete? Is my obedience complete? We can make it complete now. Brothers and sisters, this is the word of the Lord unto us. Let us rise up and say to ourselves that my WhatsApp status every day will preach Jesus. Will preach Jesus. Fine, you can add it. You can add it. Preach Jesus. Add your picture that you want to share with your friends. Interchange it. Talk about the Christ that you have heard, that has saved you. And the Lord give you understanding in Jesus' name. In summary, online evangelism is cost efficient and effective. In fact, it costs you nothing. You only have to take your phone and do it. I say it again, we have created content that you can share. And I said, if you don't like the one that the church has created, just create your own. Just write it. Just write it. People will take a passage of the scripture, For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. Write it there. All seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all of that it shall be added unto you. It's as simple as that. All the Bible versions, online Bible version, they have share link. You can share the word, brother. You can. Sister, you can if you want to. Praise the Lord. May I close with this? These days, there are digital tracts. There are digital tracts there are, you know, that you could use. A lot of them. Picture tracts, text tracts, content tracts, video tracts, a lot. The question is, are you willing? I am willing. And I pray God give you and I the grace and the understanding and the willingness to do so in Jesus' name. Amen. Shall we pray? Shall we pray? I'd like you to pray a prayer. Please, I'm begging you to pray this prayer because it is God that works in you and I to will and to do of his good pleasure. Pray this prayer with me. Say, Father, please help me to use all available digital and social platforms to evangelize the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Pray that prayer. Say, Heavenly Father, please quicken me to be willing. Remind me to do this. Please help me to use all available digital and social media platforms to evangelize the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Help me to do so. Go ahead, pray, talk to him. He will help you. I'm telling you the truth. He will remind you. If he sees that you are willing, he will remind you. The Holy Spirit knows how to remind you. If he sees that you are very willing, if he sees your heart, because he sees all hearts, if he sees that in your heart you are willing, you are really willing, he will remind you. Ask him to help you. Ask him to remind you. Father, remind us, even me, the speaker. Remind me to use my social media platform to evangelize Christ. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Peradventure, you are there, you are not born again. You are part of the people that we want to evangelize to. And you are here today on this social media platform, watching this video, or you are in the Zoom meeting right now, or you are watching this video later on as a broadcast session, and you would like to give your life to Christ, or you would like to rededicate your life to Christ. I'd like you to say this prayer after me, as it's been displayed on the screen. Say, Heavenly Father, I come to you in the name of Jesus. I confess that I need to be right with you. I ask you to please forgive me all my sins and accept me as your own. The Bible says that if I confess with my mouth that Jesus is the Lord of my life, and I believe in my heart and confess with my mouth that God raised him up from the dead, I will be saved. I believe in my heart and confess with my mouth that Jesus is Lord and Savior of my life. I thank you, Jesus, for saving me. I am so happy I'm yours now. Amen. If you have said that prayer with me, believe me honestly, you are now born again. If you are rededicating your life to Christ, you are now back in Christ. Because he said, whosoever cometh unto him, he will in no wise cast out. He will receive you. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, I thank you for those who have given their life to you right now. And those who will give their life to you as they watch this video on social media as a recorded and displayed video. Father, everyone who comes to you according to your word that you promise, please receive them. Work with them. Help them to work with you so that they do not go back to their old ways, that they may continue to work with you in this new life in the name of Jesus. Let their name remain in the book of life and let your Holy Spirit help them, leading them to a Bible-believing church very close to them, quickening them to follow you and to seek your ways. This we ask in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. God bless you. If you have made a decision to give your life to Christ and you've done so, I want you to connect with me. Because from today, God reminded me, I will be praying for you. We also want to send you some materials. Wherever you are, living all over the world, we will do so. This is what the offering people give to God is to be useful. We will send you the material wherever you are living all over the world, especially a Bible. Give us the opportunity to do this for you. Give us your name and your address or your phone number. Send this as a private message to us on whatever social media platform you're watching from. It will get to us. Our friendly team will make sure it gets to us, and I will send you these materials by the grace of God. God bless you as you do so, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. I want to encourage you all. As we have heard this tonight, let's go and be doers. Immediately tonight, don't wait till tomorrow. If you wait till tomorrow, you will not kickstart it in your life. You will not start it. And let it start tonight and continuously in your life, that from today, you began to do online evangelism for Christ using your social media platform. If you go to my Facebook page, you will see something is pinned there. It has been pinned there for the past 2 years now. Or I'm not sure. But more than 1 year, it has been pinned there. If I have new one, I will replace it. Always there. Not get Instagram. Go and do this for Christ and let God be pleased with you. When your obedience is complete, every other thing that is disobeying God's will in your life, God will be dealing with them, slashing them away. But you first of all allow your obedience to be complete, because he said to us, go ye into the world and preach the gospel to every nation. God bless you as you do so. In Jesus' precious, precious name. Amen. Amen. I'd like us to move into observing our communion. Remember I said earlier on that today's service, it's both a Bible study and a Holy Communion service. And the Holy Communion service is where we reverence the Lord, because he comes to the table with us. He said, this do in remembrance of me. He said, where we do it, wherever we gather to eat it, he said, it will be there in the midst of us. Believe me honestly, he's with you. Where you are observing the communion is with me here, because he promised. And for everybody all over the world, ever living, there's no one like Christ. It doesn't tell lies. Let's grab our communion elements now as we prepare. Let's get it ready. Get your communion elements ready, your bread and your wine. Like I always say, you could use, if you don't have unleavened bread, you can use any bread you have at home, because we are eating by faith. If you don't have, wine like a black currant drink, you can use a fruit wine. You can use a malt drink. You know, it's prophetic. We're doing it by faith. By faith, the bread becomes the flesh of Jesus. The wine becomes the blood of Jesus. By faith. And he said, this do in remembrance of me. That's why I announced on Sunday. I need to let you know this. In a church, there will be obedient people. There will always be disobedient people. But try to be on the obedient side. Obedient side. Because the Bible says, having a readiness to avenge all disobedient when your own obedience is complete. God bless you as you do so. Get your bread and your wine. We're waiting for you. As we eat, we're going to eat it together at the same time in unity. You know, God bless you as you do so, in the precious name of Jesus. Amen. All right, let's take our bread now. I like to follow the exact pattern that was as stated in the Bible. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. Let's take our bread now. And when he had given thanks, say, thank you, Jesus. Thank him for your life. Thank you, Jesus. He break it. Let's break the bread. And said, take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. Let's eat the bread now. Let's appreciate him. Thank him for your life. The Holy Communion, the bread and the wine, they bring you healing. They bring you newness of life. If you are sick out there, this is your hour. This is your hour. If somebody is sick, such a person should not be missing the Holy Communion service. This is your hour of healing. Also, if you are trusting God for anything, ask Him now. At the communion table, He's always there. He's always there. As we do it in remembrance of Him, He comes close. He promised us that we would be there. Amen. We're going to drink, take the wine now. Take your wine. After drinking the wine, if you can pray in the Holy Spirit, I mean in tongues, begin to pray in tongues if you can. But peradventure, you can't pray in tongues yet. Be appreciating Him and then ask Him for what you want Him to do for you. There's nothing difficult for God to do. Nothing too difficult. Ask Him. At the communion table, He gives you this privilege and He answers your prayer. Because you are doing this in remembrance of Him. You are drinking His blood and eating His flesh. If you are sick, this is your hour. This is your opportunity. Amen. After the seminar also, He took the cup. Let's take the cup. And when He has supped, saying, "This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as ye drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till He come." And in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen, shall we drink. Father, we thank You. Lika soko shagasi takali amale. Thank You. Thank You for this privilege. Legla de magado soko rama andala karya. Yila glade seki adosina gebaye. Emitele glede jela gladozo no domi inkalayu. Eye banasniana karo. Mole jele kote lamelai toli anarakuski yaga. Vet husi dekin amego. Hinga dusu kongiri gaya. Belia belia kolia la sakoro moshinta lava. Lord, have mercy on us. Have mercy on us in the grateful church. Have mercy on us. Send us more help. Have mercy on us. Build us. Have mercy on us. Quicken us to do Your will, to evangelize. Have mercy on us. Work in us to love You more. The love of men is waxing cold. Talk to Him. Whatever you want from God, this is what I want from Him. This is what I want from Him for His church, for His people. I'm praying in mine now. Talk to Him about yours. The love of men in your church is waxing cold. The love of men in Your kingdom is waxing cold. Quicken it, oh God. Rekindle their love. All Christians in this city, in this nation, rekindle their love. Oh, Majaku Tokolaida. All Christians over in the grateful church, rekindle their love. Rekindle their love. Help us to love You more. Help us to obey You. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Shall we pray? And so, Heavenly Father, our King, our Lord, our God, we thank You. Thank You for the privilege to come to Your table tonight. Thank You for Your presence with us as You promised. Father, we are asking all our desire and righteousness, including my prayer, Lord, to rekindle our love for You in Your mercy. Please hear our prayers. In Your mercy, please answer our prayers. Let the heart desire of Your children in righteousness, let it be full. Let it be done. Grant unto them the desires of their heart in righteousness, and let Your name alone be glorified. Holy Father, take all the glory. Righteous Father, take all the honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you, Sazama. The Lord reward you and I in the name of Jesus. Amen. When you come to the Lord's Supper, the communion table, your life do not remain the same. I want you to know this. Your life is never the same. You might not see anything physically yet, but your life is never the same spiritually. And since the spiritual controls the physical, it's a matter of time that you begin to see exploit through your life, changes, transformation, the Lord's hand upon you. Amen. Let's proceed now to give our offering, and then after that, we'll bring the service to a close. The communion table tried to come to the table with an offering for the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, precious God. The ways in which you could give are displayed on the screen. Avail yourself of this method, whichever way you want to use. But let's do well to make sure that we give to the Almighty God at this communion table. By giving to Him, we express our love. And then after we come to pray on the offering, take some few announcements, and then bring the service to a close. Praise God. Amen. All right, let us pray on our offering. Hallelujah. I want to give the privilege to, since I've been speaking, any minister online, to be honest with you, let me also just, we are all ministers, anyone online who, especially those in Zoom, anyway, those are the people that can do it, so. Anyone to pray on the offering for us? Anybody, feel free. Anybody, please feel free. Just unmute your mic and then just help us to pray on the offering, to pray. Anybody, any minister, any? Hello, anybody?
Let us pray.
Yeah, go ahead, sir.
In Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for this wonderful session tonight.
Thank you.
We glorify your holy name for bringing it to a wonderful end. We thank you because your word has gone out to us and it has enabled to heal us and deliver us from every of our destruction. We thank you, Father, for that. We glorify your holy name. Accept our thanks and praises in Jesus' name. Amen. Oh Lord, my Father, we commit our offering into your able hands, Lord. Lord, we might have brought this little out of everything that you've abundance that you've given unto us. Father Lord, please use this to glorify your kingdom in the name of Jesus. Lord, those that have none to give, Lord, please provide in the name of Jesus. We also use this offering as a point of contact. Father Lord, we'll not be in need in the name of Jesus Christ. Meet us at every point of our need in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for answering our prayer. Lord, by next week, let's give us the grace to be here also in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, sir. The Lord bless you. Amen. And that's it. We'll take a few announcements now, and then we'll bring the service to a close. Just a few announcements. Thank you. Our Sunday celebration service resumes on the 14th of April at 10 a.m. Venue, Black Chapel. I'm just grateful to God. Imagine we're reading a venue and it is our building, Platt Chapel. Thank you, Jesus. Please don't forget to subscribe. This is also another way of online evangelism. For adventure, you don't know what to write? Just share, like our Facebook page and our Facebook channel. Praise the Lord. Just do so. And before you go, now I've spoken to you about online evangelism. Yeah, I've spoken to you about online evangelism. However, in church on Sunday, we announce what I will call city evangelism. It means evangelism where we go out, we go out. You know, I have spoken with you now about online evangelism. How you do that? And that one, you can do it every day, sir. Every day. Every day. Now, citywide evangelism is when we go to the streets and we go to share the tracts. And you will notice in the great future that we do this once or twice in a month. So this Saturday, we are again, you know, coming to the city to do evangelism. Let's make sure we come out to do this, so that the Almighty God may be happy with us and see us as obedient children. We gather in church at 12 noon. Be in church before 12 noon, because by 12 noon, we begin to go out. By 12 noon, we pick the tracts. We have enough, and we begin to go out. So be in church before 12 noon. because we're going from 12 noon to 1 p.m. We're stopping by 1 p.m. Please, if you come after 1 p.m., we're already gone. If you come by 12:30, we've already gone out. You won't meet anybody in church. We've already gone out. We meet together in church, pray for like 1 minute or 2 or 3 minutes, and then we spread out in the entire area. Let's come to do this for God and see how you'll be preserving your life, keeping you alive, blessing you on every side. And not only that, you're also obeying him. He'll be happy with you. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. So please don't forget, let's share the things that have been shared on our social media platforms. Let's share it to the world and evangelize. God bless you as you do so. Let's begin to appreciate God. Thank him for a wonderful time, for a wonderful service. Glory be to you. Glory be to you. Glory be to you. Glory be to you. Glory be to God. Glory be to the Lord. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we give. Father, we thank you for a wonderful time. Thank you for speaking to us. We ask, grant us grace to be go and be doers. Don't let us go and keep quiet. Don't let us go and sit down. Let us go and be doers of this thing that you have told us. We receive grace to do so. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's share the grace and fellowship, beloved. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy follows you and I, and all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Amen and amen. God bless you, sirs and ma. Have a lovely night rest. Till I see you again on Saturday, remain blessed. Bye for now.